Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to learn how to create a product in Customily. First, I'm going to sign in with my user. And here you'll be able to see all the products I ever created. So now what we're going to do is add a new product from scratch. And for that, I will start by uploading the base EPS file. This is a very simple EPS file that contains the elements of the design that are not personalizable. This means that customers cannot change those elements. What we're going to do is add the personalizable elements right here on Customily. This will be text elements and pictures elements, so customers can upload their own pictures to the design. Perfect. So right here we can see the EPS I just uploaded, and on the right we have the controls to start adding those personalizable elements. First, I'm going to add a text. As you can see here, I can move this text around, position it, and resize it as I want, both here using the preview or using the typing the numbers on the controls. Right here, I'm gonna type some name, something for you to say. There you go. As you'll see, this text element has the unique ID 1. This is very important because it's the ID which will help us identify this element for later calling it from your store. So what I'll do is change the font size for the text. I can change the font type as well. Just choose this one, and we can assign different fonts for different positions. So in option number 2, I'm going to assign a different font so customers will be able to choose from different font styles. We can also set different colors available for different options. So for example, I can set option number 2 to have a different color. Since we're going to be engraving this product, colors don't matter for the production file, we'll just need everything to be black. So what I'm gonna do now is add an image placeholder. This is a place where customers will be able to upload their own images. And again, I will position it where it should go on the design. And as you can see, this is unique ID number 2. Now, what I'll do is test this with an image to see how this will look like when a customer uploads his own picture. Now, since this is an engraving, a color picture won't do it for us, so I'm going to change the image type to grading. That's perfect. And what we'll do as well is add a mask so we can see this as a circle. For that, we upload a mask, which is a very simple black and white picture, like this one, that will tell our image that it should only show the elements within the circle. There we go. So this is pretty much everything for the production file. We're going to hit next and go over to setting up the preview, which is what will show when customers visit your store. The first thing to do is set a background image. This is just a simple picture of the product, again, without the personalizable fields. Now what we're going to do is position the elements we created on the previous steps on the preview so they look realistic. Again, I'm going to try how that looks with an image so we can reposition it and place it where it should go. We can also change colors for the picture to make it look more realistic. We can add opacity to it, transparency. And the same goes with text. I'll reposition it there, change the color to make it look more realistic. We can see here how the different fonts are still available. And this is what we do to make the preview look good. One extra thing we can add for the preview is dynamic images. These images are meant for elements that change the preview but do not affect the production file. For example, the color of the wood. If a customer chooses a different color of the wood, the production file will still be the same because it's the same engraving that's going to be made. But we are going to use a different base for that. So what I'll do is add a dynamic image, and here we're going to upload the different colors available for the wooden board. What I'll do is resize this to fit with the board. And now I'm going to upload the different pictures for that. Here I've got a picture for the option number one, which is light wood. And now I'm going to upload a picture for position number two, which will be dark wood. This is the third element we add, that's why it has unique ID number 3. And what I'm going to do is move this backwards so I can see the elements I had created before. And one last thing, I'm going to change the color for this font for position number 2 so it will match this darker wood. Perfect. And with that, we are all set for creating our product. I'm just gonna hit done and go to the final step, which is the reviewing step, where we can see what we created on the production file and on the preview. Here we are, and now I can see the production file and the preview, and see that if I type something here, this is what customers will see online on your product page, and this is the file you'll get once they submit the order. Let's try with a test image as well. And there we go. Everything works perfectly, so I'm going to go ahead and save this file. And that's it. This gives us our product ID, which is very important because this is the ID we're going to use to link this. Everything was set up here with your actual product on your store. But this is going to come on another video. So thank you very much. Bye bye.